Hi, everyone, and welcome to Machine Learning in 15, getting started with generative AI using Amazon SageMaker. My name is Heiko Otz. I'm a specialist solution architect for AI and machine learning at AWS. And today I'm joined by Philip. Philip, you want to quickly introduce yourself?
Yeah, hi, everyone. My name is Philip. I'm technical lead at Hugging Face, and I'm also an AWS machine learning hero. Happy to be here today.
Awesome. Cool. So today we want to show you a little bit about AWS's partnership with Hugging Face and also how you can get started with generative AI with Hugging Face on AWS and in particular SageMaker. But for those folks, there's probably only a few people out there who don't know what Hugging Face is, Philip, but for those folks, would you quickly mind sharing what exactly is Hugging Face?
Sure. Yeah. So Hugging Face, we are a startup coming out of Paris and also are in New York. And we are currently building the GitHub for machine learning. I guess it's the easiest way to describe what we are doing. We are having a platform called the Hugging Face Hub, which is currently hosting over 200,000 machine learning models and 30,000 different data sets. And also since I would say like 1 year roughly, 85,000 machine learning demos called Spaces. And in addition to this, we are also the creator of the popular machine learning libraries, transformers, diffusers, and datasets, which makes it super easy for you to build generative AI applications.
Cool. And for those who don't know, Hugging Face and AWS have been partnering actually since 2021. And Philip, can you share a little bit like this partnership all entails?
Yes, so we partnered with AWS to make generative AI and machine learning in general more accessible to everyone. We have integrated all of our solutions into AWS, including our SaaS solutions with Inference Endpoint and Spaces as marketplace offerings. We also provide our premium support called Expert Acceleration program on the marketplace for companies to directly subscribe through AWS to the experts we have at Hugging Face. Together with the SageMaker team, we built first-party integrations and solutions for the Amazon SageMaker service, including deep learning containers for the Hugging Face libraries. We built something called the Hugging Face Inference Toolkit, which makes it super easy to deploy transformers and diffusers models. And we have integrated already over 200 different models into Jumpstart, including new foundation models like Llama or Falcon. And that's not basically where we stop. We also are working very closely with the AWS Silicon team to make sure that all of the popular Hugging Face transformer model and diffuser models can be run on AWS Trainium and Inferentia 2 and also now Inferentia 2. And that's super exciting. That's, I think, like the most exciting thing we are currently working on. And we have created a new open source library called Optimum Neuron, which basically makes it super easy to switch from one accelerator to Trainium or Inferentia with basically one line of code change.
That is pretty awesome. And it does already eliminate some of the customer pain points because, as we all know, GPU instances are quite rare and hard to come by these days. But what are some of the other customer pain points? Like Hugging Face, obviously, it's great that, you know, all these large language models are now available freely and openly on Hugging Face. But, you know, what are the, like, when you actually want to run these large language models, there's still a few pain points, I would assume. What are some of those?
Yeah, when speaking with customers who are, like, interested in getting started with generative AI and especially deploying LLMs, we basically came across of some similar pattern. And one of the, like you mentioned it already, computational resources, LLMs or like generative AI models require a lot of memory and computational power to run efficiently, which leads to specific hardware requirements. So oftentimes LLMs are too big to fit on a single GPU, meaning you would need to parallelize those models, which is not very easy and straightforward. And then in addition to once you manage to parallelize those models, latency and throughput is also super critical since, for example, if you want to build a conversational application, you want to have fast responses for your customers. So latency is super critical. And then also, okay, you want to scale efficiently your predictions. So throughput is like basically also super important to focus on. And once you have created those solutions, you need to make sure those are running. And LLMs, our generative AI applications, are a bit different to, I would say, traditional software applications, since the machine learning part is like super important and you are writing less code, but you need to invest more into like prompt engineering, for example, to make sure that you have behaviors even when updating your model. And then, of course, security and governance is like super important. We currently have a lot of those closed source API black box solutions where customers basically don't know how the model is trained on and what happens behind the scenes. And with open source LLMs, we can basically make sure that we apply to all of the security standards and compliance from big companies.
Gotcha. And to overcome these challenges, like what have you been working on recently together with the AWS team to overcome these challenges?
Yeah, super exciting. To solve those pain points, basically, we created something called the Hugging Face LLM Inference Container for Amazon SageMaker. So before we had our inference container for the Hugging Face libraries, and we have created now a purpose-built container only for deploying and managing LLMs in an efficient and secure way. And yeah, that's basically what we can see here. And we have already talked about it, how hard it is to deploy LLMs, and with TGI we are handling all of those heavy liftings with model parallelism or making sure that latency and throughput is mostly optimized.
You mentioned TGI, the text generation inference library. Can you talk a little bit more about that, the TGI library?
So the LLM container is basically leveraging text generation inference, which is our purpose-built solution for serving large language models. And initially, TGI was created to serve Plume for our customer, which was released mid last year and was, or I think is still, the biggest open available LLM with 176 billion parameter. And leading from like all of the interest and seeing companies being interested in deploying LLMs throughout the last year, we have created this new solution called TGI, which basically solves all of the challenges we have seen and talked about earlier. TGI implements model parallelism through tensor parallelism. We have created dedicated and optimized modeling code and custom CUDA kernels to accelerate latency. We are using, for example, flash attention to reduce memory and to increase the throughput. And I think one of the coolest features is streaming, where you can basically stream the response to your client and make sure you have like a great user experience. And TGI currently supports all of the popular open available LLMs, including Plume, Llama, Falcon, Starcoder, T5.
Cool. And when you say Llama and T5, these are the model architectures, right? So that means
yes,
the newer models like Flan UL2 or Llama 2, those are also supported.
Yes, exactly.
Cool. Right. So this sounds like you put a lot of engineering effort into that. Like, does that mean it's quite complicated then for me to use all these features and services that you just mentioned?
No, like using the new LLM container is like super easy. We basically made it compatible with existing UX and DX experiences. We just have created this new container following a similar API schema, meaning that you can like deploy, for example, here, Falcon 40B instruct with 10 lines of code, or rather saying two modeling calls. We still have the Hugging Face model, which is a SageMaker class coming from the SageMaker SDK, where you define the image you want to use. Here we are using the new LLM image. We define in our environment configuration the model we want to deploy and the number of GPUs or where we want to distribute it. We have a role with our IAM credentials, hit deploy, and then we are ready to serve it. And SageMaker will basically handle all of the infrastructure management behind the scenes.
That is pretty awesome. And I actually already tried out this new LLM inference container. And yeah, let's change gears a little bit, get away from the slides. I've been playing around with this LLM inference container, and what I really liked about it is, first of all, as you mentioned, Philip, how easy it is to deploy the Falcon model. And then the second thing that really surprised me in a positive way was how quickly the inference requests will be responded by this container. So it's really rather quick to set up the model and then to build an LLM application on top of that.
Can you explain what you have created with your demo or what your demo can do?
Yeah, so when we speak to customers, oftentimes what they want to do is they want to interrogate their documents, all the knowledge that is buried within an organization, that is buried in documents, is usually not very well discoverable. So they want a ChatGPT-like experience, but obviously they want to do that in a secure and private manner because they don't always want to send inference requests and data to these black box APIs that you mentioned earlier.
And
So,
secure means that no data is leaving the customer environment, or what does security means here?
So basically, that's exactly right. We have here a very simplified architecture diagram, but we have deployed the Falcon 40B instruct model via the LLM inference container into a SageMaker endpoint. And then on top of that, we have built the chatbot application, the document Q&A chatbot application with a web UI and a memory component that will then interact with the model. And the nice thing is everything happens within your AWS account. So, the document itself is only going to be in your AWS account, and all the inference requests also are just going to happen within your AWS account. So actually no data ever leaves your account.
That's super cool. Can you share me the demo, how it works, and can we ask something?
Let's do that. So this is the web UI, and I just built this with Streamlit. It's very easy to set up. And basically, what I can do here is I can upload a document, in this case, a financial report, the Amazon Q1 results from 2023. I'm going to upload that to the model. And then it says, I've read the file. And then you can start, chatting with your document. It's like, first of all, what is this report about? And then it tells me, it's the first quarterly earnings of the fiscal year 2023. How high was the revenue? And I don't need to specify because it's all keeping it in memory or in context. I don't even need to specify that it needs to refer back to this report. It will know automatically that it now needs to query the financial report and comes back with this number, which if you were to double check that, that's exactly the right number. So with that, we even eliminate or very much reduce the possibility of any hallucinations.
Super cool. And if I now would be interested in deploying it, where would I start?
One second. it's very easy. So this GitHub repo is openly available, and the whole code is I think around 113 lines of code. So you can start there and then improve up on, because this is a very simplified demo right now. But you could easily improve upon that as well. But it's
Super
all with
cool.
open source libraries. So,
Awesome. Thanks.
All right. And I think that's all we wanted to share today. Thanks so much for tuning in. And do let us know. Philip and I are available on Twitter, LinkedIn. If you have any questions around this, please feel free to reach out. Thanks.
Thanks, bye.